Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about Newton's law of cooling. As of now, we have discussed about specific heat capacity, change of state, and also we discussed about latent heat. In this class, we are going to discuss about Newton's law of cooling. For example, you know, when you take some hot water or milk, when you kept it on the table, when tea is kept it on the table surface like this and left it alone for some time, the temperature of the hot water decreases and temperature of the surroundings increases. This will happen up to the temperature of hot tea and surroundings both are equal. That means this flow will occur until both temperature surroundings will get up to thermal equilibrium. Okay, we will study how a given body can cool. That means how can this given body can cool on exchanging heat with its surroundings. For this, let us perform an experiment. Take a vessel like this. And say some amount of water is taken in the vessel. Say up to half liter water is there in the beaker like this. I pour 500 ml of water in this beaker and note down the temperature of this water using a thermometer. Consider it is a thermometer. Note down the initial temperature of water in the beaker. That means the initial temperature indicates the temperature of the surroundings. That means here I am noting down the temperature of the surroundings or initial temperature of water or initial temperature of body, which is equal to temperature of surroundings. Let initial temperature of surroundings is equal to T1 degree Celsius. And now I am heating this water. Up to 40 degrees above the surroundings temperature. 40 degrees above the surroundings temperature. Say if the surroundings temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, heat the water in the beaker up to 40 degrees above the surroundings temperature. That means heat the water inside the beaker up to until it gets the temperature of 60 degrees Celsius. When the water attains 40 degrees above the surroundings temperature, that means nearly 60 degrees centigrade, now remove the heat source. Now water in the beaker. Is at high temperature. Okay. That high temperature is nothing but the T2. Now, take the stop clock, and I am taking the stop clock. Allow the hot water to interact with surroundings now, and take the readings of thermometer scale after every regular intervals of time, say 1 minute. Initial temperature of the surroundings is nothing but T1. Water, when it is heated up to 40 degrees above the surroundings temperature, let it be T2. Now I removed the heat source, and I am allowing the water to interact with surroundings, so the temperature of water decreases. Now I am going to record the values of temperature of the hot water in regular intervals of time. Suppose for every 1 minute, take the reading. Okay, After 1 minute, let the temperature falls from 60 degrees to 55 degrees Celsius like this. Okay, after 1 minute. Let us consider this is nothing but temperature difference here is nothing but delta T is nothing but T2 minus T1. After one more minute, and take the temperature of the hot water. That hot water is let T2, and now the change in temperature of hot water and surroundings temperature is nothing but T2 minus T1. After one more minute, that means 2 minutes, after 3 minutes, now the temperature of the body is T2, and record the temperature of the body using thermometer, and change in temperature in this case is T2 minus T1 again. After 4 minutes, record the temperature of hot water, that is T2, and now calculate change in temperature, that is temperature of hot water minus temperature of the initial temperature of the surroundings. Do this similar thing for some time in the regular intervals of time of 1 minute. Now I am drawing a graph between change in temperature versus time in minutes. Okay, change in temperature is in Celsius degrees, like this. So at t equal to 0 minutes, initially the water is at 40 degrees above the surroundings temperature. Let us say it is about 60 degrees Celsius. After 1 minute, the temperature difference is 60 minus initial temperature. Let us say initial temperature is 20. 60 minus 20 is nothing but 40 degrees Celsius somewhat. After 1 minute, it will be like this. When I draw the graph between change in temperature versus time interval, I will get a graph like this. You also can perform this experiment if you have stopwatch as well as thermometer, clinical thermometer. You will get a graph in this shape. That means from this graph, we can say that in first 1 minute, the temperature drops from here to here. The drop in temperature is more. And in second minute, the drop in temperature is up to this much. And in third minute, the drop in temperature is less. And in fourth minute, the drop in temperature is still less. Okay, so if the temperature of the body is more, the rate of cooling also will be more. So when you heat the water with the help of a heater, immersion heater, don't let the water to allow directly hot water to allow, don't let the water directly allow to interact with surroundings. Add some, because initially the hot water is at high temperature when you remove the immersion heater from the bucket. So you should pour some amount of water, cool amount of water, so the temperature will be dropped down. But the temperature of water is above the surroundings temperature. But the temperature difference between hot water and surroundings temperature is less. If temperature difference is less, the rate of cooling is also less. So instead of leaving the water, boiling water, which is at 100 degrees Celsius, in order to contact with surroundings, as the temperature difference is 100 degrees Celsius minus 20 degrees Celsius. 100 degrees Celsius is nothing but temperature of boiling water, and 20 degrees Celsius is nothing but temperature of surroundings. So now the temperature difference is 80 degrees Celsius. As the temperature difference is more, the rate of cooling is also more from this graph. So what should you do in this case? You should pour some amount of cold water in boiling water. Let after pouring the boiling water, let the temperature of the water combination is now let it be 50 or 60 degrees, and now the surroundings temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, and the temperature difference in this case is 40 or 30 degrees Celsius. As the temperature difference between hot body and surroundings temperature surroundings is less, so rate of cooling is less in this case. So this is the advantage of mixing cold water with boiling water. Okay, now I am concluding here. The rate of cooling is higher initially. The rate of cooling is higher and decreases. Rate of cooling decreases as the temperature of the body, falls down. So now, according to the law of cooling, Newton's law of cooling, the rate of loss of heat. Who is losing heat energy here? Hot body is losing heat energy. The rate of loss of heat is directly proportional to change in temperature. Change in temperature of what? Change in temperature of hot body and surroundings. Surroundings temperature is T1 and hot body temperature is T2. We know it. So Newton's law of cooling, as per Newton's law of cooling, the rate of loss of heat energy is directly proportional to change in temperature of hot body and surroundings. If change in temperature is less, the rate of cooling is also less. That means the rate of loss of heat energy is also less. So now, rate of heat energy is nothing but dq by dt. As the heat energy is losing, so loss of heat energy is indicated with negative sign. Minus dq by dt is directly proportional to what? Change in temperature of the hot body and surroundings, that is T2 minus T1. By removing proportionality symbol, we will get some constant. Dq by dt is equal to some constant K into T2 minus T1 here. Let this equation number 1. Okay. And rate of cooling or loss of heat energy, rate of cooling depends on area of surface area of the body and nature of the substance. The loss of heat energy depends on what? Surface area of the body, and also depends on nature of the substance. Let mass of the hot body is M, and its specific heat capacity is S, and initial temperature of body is T2 temperature of hot body is T2. So change in temperature of hot body, not change in temperature of hot body and surroundings, a change in temperature of hot body, change in temperature of hot body is dT2. Therefore now dQ is equal to ms change in temperature of hot body dT2, ms dT2. I am taking rate of heat energy now. Rate of heat energy is nothing but dQ by dT is equal to ms dT2 by dT. Now loss of heat energy. Loss is nothing but we keep negative sign here in front. Loss of heat energy minus dQ by dT is equal to simply minus ms dT2. Therefore, I am replacing minus dQ by dT with minus ms dT2. So, from equation 1, minus ms dT2 is equal to some k into T2 minus T1. On rearranging the terms, I will get dT2 divided by T2 minus T1 is equal to minus k by m into s into dQ by dT. I am writing rate of heat energy. dQ by dT is nothing but dT is there, and so here also dT is there, so dT by dT is there. Alright, I am writing minus k by ms into dT. Okay, so here I am considering small k by m into s equal to simply I am considering it as capital K. So therefore dT2 divided by T2 minus T1 is equal to minus capital K into change in time. dT is nothing but change in time. Let us consider this is equation number 2. Integrating both sides. Integrating both sides with respect to time. On integrating both sides. So integral 1 by T2 minus T1 into dT2 is equal to minus k into integral dT. So integral of 1 by x, we know integral of 1 by x dx is nothing but ln x, or also we call it as log base e of x. Ln x is also equivalent to log base e of x, and we know integral dt is nothing but simply t. So this is nothing but log base e of t2 minus t1 is equal to minus k into integral dt is nothing but t, and we will get some constant, integration constant c, minus kt plus c. So when this log comes to right side, log base e will become exponential. Therefore t2 minus t1 is equal to exponential of minus kt plus c. That is nothing but exponential of minus kt into exponential of c. Therefore, t2 minus t1 is equal to e power minus kt into e power c. Write e power c as c dash. Therefore, I am writing it as c dash. Now, this is the final expression. See here, if I am taking change in temperature on y-axis, change in temperature on y-axis and time on x-axis, this is taken on y-axis, so it is in the form of y equal to e power minus kx. That means y changes exponentially, decreases, negative sign indicates decreases exponentially with respect to time. So exponential curve is nothing but like this, and decreasing, so I am writing like this. So as t2 minus t1 in relation with the time, as it decreases exponentially, change in temperature decreases exponentially with respect to time. Negative sign indicates decreases. T2 minus T1 decreases exponentially. Negative sign indicates decreases exponentially with respect to time. So, from this expression also, we arrived at the same graph as we have discussed in the beginning. Okay? Right. Now, when I take the graph between logarithm of T2 minus T1 and time, we will get a shape like this. So, I am writing x-axis like this and y-axis like this. On y-axis I am taking, what I am taking on y-axis, logarithm of t2 minus t1, and on x-axis I am taking t like this. Okay, so it is in the form of y. Log t2 minus t1 is taken on y-axis, so y is equal to minus k, time is taken on x-axis, minus kx. So, y is equal to minus kx. Y equal to minus kx is nothing but what? It is a straight line equation having negative slope. We will get a shape like this. Straight line equation with negative slope. Okay. So, this is the end of this chapter. I am going to explain some examples with you here, and now the first example related to this question is example number 12.8. Here example number 12.8 is, see here, yes, a pan filled with hot water, hot food, cools from 94 degrees Celsius to 86 degrees Celsius. So here, the temperature of hot body, here, temperature of hot body, T2. The T2 is changing from where to where? 94 to 86. So I am taking the average of, in order to find out T2 value, I am taking the average of 94 and 86. We will get 90 degrees Celsius. This is the average temperature of hot body. The time taken to cool from 94 degrees Celsius to 82 degrees Celsius, that is change in time dt, is equal to how much? It is 2 minutes. When the room temperature is at 20 degrees Celsius, that means surroundings temperature T1 is equal to 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, now T2 minus T1 is equal to, in this case T2 minus T1 equal to 90 minus 20 is nothing but 70 Celsius degrees. 70 Celsius degrees. So here, from equation number 2, What is equation number 2? dT2, change in temperature of the body divided by T2 minus T1 is equal to some constant into dT. So I'm writing from equation 2, dT2 divided by T2 minus T1 is equal to some constant K into change in time, that is time interval. So here dT2 is nothing but the change in temperature of hot body is nothing but initially it was 94 and final was 86. So change in temperature of hot body is equal to 94 minus 86. Final minus initial, 86 minus 94. So 86 minus 94. Change in temperature is nothing but minus 8 Celsius degrees. So I am writing like this, minus 8 Celsius degrees divided by T2 minus T1. T2 minus T1, we got it as 70 is equal to minus K into dT. dT is nothing but change in time. How much the time taken? 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Consider this is equation number A. Okay. And in second case, how long will it take? We need to find out dT value. Will it take when it cools from 71 degrees Celsius to 69 degrees Celsius? Now T2 is equal to average of temperatures, that is 71 plus 69 divided by 2, average is 70 Celsius degrees. So the change in temperature of hot body temperature changes from 71 to 69, that is 69 minus 71 equal to minus 2 Celsius degrees. Okay, now the change in temperature of hot body and surroundings is equal to 70 minus surroundings temperature is how much? 20, which is nothing but 50 Celsius degrees. So I am applying this equation again for the second case, case 2. In case 2, dT2 divided by T2 minus T1 is equal to minus K into dT. So from here we will get dT2 in the second case. dT2 is how much? Minus 2 Celsius degrees divided by T2 minus T1 is how much? 50, which is equal to minus K into how much? We don't know the change in the time taken, the amount of time taken, we don't know it. We need to find out this value. So let us consider this is equation number B. So now I am doing A by B, doing equation A by B, that is equal to minus 8 by 70 is equal to minus K into 2 minutes divided by minus 2 divided by 50 is equal to minus K into dT. Okay, so here minus and minus get cancels, minus and minus get cancels. So now I can write like this as 80 by 70 into 50 by 2, 8 by 70 into 50 by 2 is equal to this K and K get cancels, 2 minutes divided by dT, right hand side. Okay, so now this 0 and 0 get cancels, 2 1 ja, 2 4 ja. Okay, so I will get 2, 4 into 5, 20. 20 divided by 7 is equal to 2 minutes divided by dT. So here dT is equal to, on cross multiplying we will get like this, dT is equal to 2 minutes into 7 by 20, that is 2 1 ja, 2 10 ja, 7 by 10 minutes. 7 by 10 minutes is nothing but what? 0.7 minutes. So dT, the amount of time taken to cool down from 71 degree Celsius to 69 degree Celsius is how much? 0.7 minutes. This is the answer. Okay. Right. Now I am going to explain the example number 12.4. Wait a minute. Right. I'm going to explain this example now. See here. Right. When 0.15 kg of ice of 0 degree Celsius mixed with 0.3 kg of water at 50 degree Celsius in a container, the resulting temperature, final temperature, is 6.7 degree Celsius. Calculate the heat of fusion of ice. Latent heat of fusion of ice. We need to find out latent heat of fusion in this case. So here in this example, the mass of ice, mass of ice is equal to how much? 0.1 kg. And initially the ice is at 0 degree Celsius. Ice at 0 degree Celsius initially. Mixed with water, the amount of water is how much? The mass of water is equal to 0.3 kg, and its initial temperature of water, for water, initial temperature of water, initial temperature of water equal to 50 degrees Celsius in a container. Both are mixed in a container. The resulting temperature is, and final temperature, now the final temperature of both water and final temperature of water is equal to how much? 6.7 degrees Celsius. This is the final temperature. So who is losing heat here? Water losing the heat. So heat energy lost by water. Its temperature decreasing from where to where? 50 to 6.7 degrees Celsius. So heat lost by water equal to heat gained by ice to melt. First of all, the water will be melted. Sorry, the ice will be melted into water. Some amount of heat energy taken from the water will be utilized to melt the ice to water. And when the total amount of ice is melted into water, the remaining energy gained from the water will be utilized to increase the temperature of water at 0 degree Celsius to 6.7 degree Celsius. So heat gained by ice to melt into water, plus when total ice is get converted into water at 0 degree Celsius, now heat absorbed by water at 0 degree Celsius will be utilized to increase its temperature from 0 to 6.7 degree Celsius. So heat gained by ice to melt plus heat gained to raise the temperature from where to where? 0 degree Celsius to 6.7 degree Celsius. So heat lost by water, The water temperature is changing from where to where? 50 degrees Celsius to 6.7 degrees Celsius. So when the temperature is changing, we need to apply specific heat capacity formula. So specific heat capacity is equal to Q by delta Q by M delta T. So from here, heat energy delta Q is equal to MS delta T. Therefore, we use this equation here. And also we know latent heat is nothing but amount of heat energy required per unit mass substance to change its state from one to another is called latent heat of substance. Okay, from here, when the state of a system, when the state of a substance is changing from one state to another state, we change this equation, heat absorbed equal to M into L. When state changes, we follow this equation. When temperature changes, we follow this equation, MS delta T. So heat lost by water, whenever the temperature is falling from, changing from 50 to 6.7 degrees Celsius, we use this equation. So MS delta T, so of water, heat lost. Heat lost is nothing but what we indicate with negative sign, is equal to heat gained by ice to melt. Here melting is taking place. So we use this equation ML because change of state is occurring from ice to water. ML, M into L of ice plus when total ice get converted into water at 0 degrees Celsius. Now the remaining heat absorbed will be utilized to increase the temperature from 0 to 6.7 degrees Celsius. So here temperature is changing. So we should use this heat energy formula, that is MS delta T of water or ice or water at 0 degrees Celsius, water at 0 degrees Celsius to 6.7 degrees Celsius. So now I am minus solving this, keeping minus. Mass of the water is equal to how much? Mass of the water equal to 0.3 kg into specific heat of water. Specific heat of water is how much? 4186. 4186 joule per kilogram per Kelvin into change in temperature of water. Water final temperature is 6.7 minus initial temperature is 50. 6.7 minus 50, which is equal to mass of the ice. Mass of the ice is how much? 0.15 kg. 0.15 into latent heat of fusion. Why I am calling it as fusion? Because ice melted into water. Latent heat of melting is equal to latent heat of fusion. So M into L plus this mass is nothing but mass of the ice that is converted into water. Mass of the ice that is converted into water is how much? 0.15 kg into specific heat capacity of ice. Specific heat capacity of ice is nothing but 2100, or we also can, specific heat capacity of water is nothing but 4186 into change in temperature. Final temperature is 6.7 minus initial temperature is 0. So here what is unknown? This is known, this is known, this is known, this is known, this is unknown. By solving this formula, this equation, you will get LF is equal to 3.34. Latent heat of fusion is equal to 3.34 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per kg. Okay, so this is the answer for this question. Thank you. Have a nice day, students. Bye bye.